Hello everyone, welcome back to another video. We are doing a push day today. Haven't done a push day in a while. Last time we've done a push day on this channel, it probably would have been like a month ago. So don't be afraid. I have still trained push. It is still my weak point, so I'm still hitting it regularly twice a week. It just hasn't lined up with one of the videos, but today's your lucky day. You're gonna see my itty bitty titty, as people say. So yeah, chest day. Just on my way to the gym now. I'll see you all in there. So, we are now here in my home gym, my main gym. You would have seen me last week in Birmingham, but don't worry, I haven't left London. London is still where I live. Sorry, bro. So yeah, this is MuscleWorks Gym. It's one of, I think in my opinion, it's the best bodybuilding gym in London for both the equipment, the space, the location, and the price. Or I think all of it's top notch. I haven't been to one that's better, in a better location, cheaper, etc. So yeah, if any of you are in London, do pay a visit. You might find me here as well. But yeah. It is actually 5.5 weeks out today, exactly. Now, without further ado, we get into the video. Warming up the shoulders now. Well, warming up, correction, stretching. Stretching out the shoulders. A lot of you lot where you always feel like shoulder pain when you're incline pressing and all that lot, that's because you're not stretching before your push days. I think stretching out the shoulders is really important. It's one of those things where it's leveraged and used in so many movements. Obviously when you train shoulders it's used, but also push movements. Even tricep stuff is used to stabilize it. It's all activated. And I think a lot of people nowadays have a lot of shoulder problems because they don't actually take the time to get quality stretches and warm-ups in and get some blood flow to the shoulders before you push. Which is why, as a matter of fact, the first movement of every push day I do, whether it's the first or the second push day of the week, I always start with the lateral raise movement to get some blood to the shoulders. So when we get to a heavy pressing, the shoulder feels well oiled. It's like you can't use a machine to lift heavy load if it's not got WD-40 in it and it just becomes cranky. And the way we kind of emulate that for the human body, for the shoulder joint, in my opinion, it's the blood flow. When it's warm, when it's pumped, it feels more stable. You can use it to shoulder more as well because it's got a pump already to stabilize during your heavy pressing movements. And then if you're warming up the side delts, you might as well do like a couple, 2 to 3 working sets. Because again, you can train to failure and it's not taxing your body at all. It doesn't tax any of your CNS. So always stretch your shoulders. And if you want, start your push day out with a lateral raise movement. Elite bench, the new bench. Do some good quality reps, you know? I'll go up by one. So the pre-workout is kicking in. Funnily enough, I've only had a couple sips, and it might be like a, what do you call it? What? Placebo. Yeah. It might be a placebo effect, but I'm getting a little bit jittery, a little bit tingly, and I've only had like a couple sips, so either my caffeine tolerance is actually really low, or it's placebo. I think it's a bit of both. For context, I think the daily recommended dose is supposedly 400. I'm not a medical expert, so don't crucify me if it's not, but I think it's about like 400 milligrams and I never go anywhere near that. But with my daily intake, my pre-workout is 150 milligrams of caffeine. I have some dark chocolate in my diet. That will amount to like probably like 40 for the day max. And the only other caffeine I take at the moment is probably the caffeine from Coke Zero, which I think is about 50 milligrams. I will actually start implementing more caffeine, because caffeine's a hunger suppressant or suppressor. Suppresses hunger, basically. And I'm getting to the point where like, I'm really hungry, so I need to use caffeine to kind of suppress my hunger a bit more. So I'll start having Red Bulls, but not the normal Red Bulls, because I think they taste grim. I love the summer edition ones, specifically the, I think it's pronounced Karuba, an elderflower flavor, the green ones, 250 milliliters. And they got 80 milligrams of caffeine, so half of what's in a Monster, half of my pre-workout. But still, I'm still, even with the Red Bull, I'm still nowhere touching 400, because 80 plus 150 on pre and then 40 in the dark chocolate. That's why I can lift now with half the pre-workout finished. And then that also means I can save my pre-workout for my next heavy pressing movement as well. So the benefits of having, you know, just not abusing caffeine, it's actually very good in terms of working out and bodybuilding. So there we go. I don't really care whether I match a weight and reps. I just care about training to failure. Like, if I am able to train to failure, I take that as a win. If I'm able to train intensely, or like with one rep in reserve, for example, I take that as a win. The only thing I won't be happy about, if I miss reps, or if I lift slightly lighter than before and I'm getting ever so slightly weaker, I'm not really fixated on that much more anymore. I'm just kind of fixated to not allowing myself to stop anywhere shy of one rep in reserve. And if that's the case, I get weaker. I mean, I'm on like well over 1,000 deficit at the moment every single day. So if I'm lifting the same amount of stuff as I was on my bulk, then I'd be on some pretty heavy doses, and I'm pretty sure I'd be kicked out of the Natural Federation. So yeah. Normally what I do is I do a reverse pyramid. So my top set, my first working set, is the heaviest. I go to failure and the rep range is the lowest. And then each successive set, I drop the weight up the rep range slightly, still to failure. But then the last set is the lightest and the most reps. So that's kind of the reverse pyramid I follow off and on season. But yeah, I've gotten to this point in prep now where, instead, focus less on the weight and reps and go to failure. So this is a prime example of that, where on my first set I did 8 reps, and then on my second set I dropped the weight and did 10 reps, and then I dropped it more and I was aiming for 12, but I failed at like 7 on my last set. So that's a prime example where, you know, if I cared so much about reps and matching it, I'd be defeated. But I'm at that point where like I failed at 7 reps. That means I trained to failure. I'll take it. So yeah, onto some shoulder press. Monster was here before us and was just like incline, the shoulder pressing 3 plates aside.
I have my
Yeah. I'm a bit weak now, so I'll probably do 15s in the first instead of 20s. But I'll sort the bench out first because I like to face a mirror. Not because I'm a narcissist, but
you sure?
Just so I can make sure I hit depth. I really like this machine. The only criticism I have for it is that it doesn't converge. So if you're lucky enough to use like the Prime or the Atlantis chest press, you'd know that, well, I think gym mates do them as well, where like you stretch at the bottom and then you converge at the top. It's slightly, I feel like it's more comfortable. You get a better squeeze and a stretch. This one doesn't, it just goes straight out and straight in, but I still get a filthy pump from it, so it's worked for me in the off season. No reason why it wouldn't work in the drone prep as well, so keeping this in. Matt is judging me right now because I'm using the machine.
Any free weights in this session?
0
free weights. There's a Smith.
Cameraman that's exposed you, don't worry.
Cameraman snitch on you.
Cameraman snitch on you, quick.
Man, snitches in this gym everywhere. Will. Triceps.
0 free weights.
Lateral raises. I'll do some dumbbells.
For the camera.
Yeah, for Matt actually, just for him.
Thank you.
5 and a half weeks out of push day done. A little bit of posing as you saw. I think prep at this point, energy's low, food is low, cardio is high, as you heard earlier, 9 hours a week. So fatigue is setting in pretty gnarly now. It's one of those things where it's actually really hard for me to look too far into the future. I just kind of have to take it day by day. I know everyone says this, but that's because it is actually true. So basically, the attitude I'm taking now is every day I'm just thinking, okay, what session am I hitting today? What food do I need to eat? How much cardio I have to do? And that's all I'm thinking about in terms of prep. Not really thinking about the day after. Just trying to get all the list, these little micro things ticked, so that if I do that every single day, it'll kind of roll over. So yeah, that's a little prep update for you all. Sleep is still pretty good, fortunately. So yeah, next time I'll see you, I'll give you all another update. But for now, thank you for watching. Remember, liking and subscribing to the video, please. Really helps me out a lot. And I will see you all next time. Hope you have a nice day.